हे गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल। और अभी मैं इस पोजीशन में इसलिए हूँ क्योंकि मैं आज कुछ केसेस डिस्कस करना चाहूंगा आप लोगों के साथ, जो मेरे इस वीक के केसेस हैं। कुछ जो इम्पोर्टेंट केसेस, अच्छे केसेस मैं आप लोगों को दिखाऊंगा और किस तरीके से डायग्नोसिस, ट्रीटमेंट प्लानिंग उसको करेंगे उसके बारे में जस्ट इट विल बी अ डिस्कशन। एंड इफ यू आर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, आई एम डॉक्टर अभिषेक एंड आई एम वर्किंग एज अ रीडर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ओरल मेडिसिन भुवनेश्वर। And I make videos on dentistry, anything you can relate to dentistry, right? So, ये है मेरा X-rays और let's see one patient, our first case. So I have chosen this case because the patient came with severe pain in the 3-8 region, in the left lower back tooth region. अब the patient when she came to my clinic, she was around more than 65 years of age and she had only hypertension. So what is important here, the periapical lesion you see here, aap agar aap periapical lesion ka matlab dekhna chahte hain to ye ek periapical lesion hai yahan pe, and this tooth was carious from the proximal end as you can see here. But the question jo dilemma mein hai ki patient का अगर मैं इस टूथ को एक्सट्रैक्ट कर दूंगा, राइट, इफ आई एक्सट्रैक्ट दिस टूथ, स्टिल द पेशेंट विल हैव पेन। यू नो व्हाई? बिकॉज देर इज अ डिस्टल कैरीज इन द 7 ऑल्सो, विच इज, देखिए फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मैं आपको ये बताना चाहता हूं कि व्हेन आई वाज अबाउट टू एक्सट्रैक्ट दिस टूथ, आई वाज थिंकिंग नॉट टू टेक द एक्सरे, बट आई थॉट कि इफ द पेशेंट इज हैविंग पेन, लेट मी टेक अ एक्सरे। सो द प्री ऑप एक्सरे इज वेरी मच नेसेसरी। तो हियर यू कैन सी देयर इज अ डिस्टल कैरीज, प्रॉक्सिमल डिस्टल प्रॉक्सिमल कैरीज इन द 7 ऑल्सो। सो दैट मीन्स इवन आफ्टर एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ द टूथ, दिस टूथ हैज टू बी ट्रीटेड एज वेल इन ऑर्डर टू कंप्लीटली रिलीव ऑफ द पेन इफ द व्हाट एवर द पेशेंट इज गेटिंग। सो आई टोल्ड द पेशेंट फॉर द रूट कैनाल ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ दिस टूथ एंड एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ, आई हैव एक्सट्रैक्टेड दिस टूथ and this is she will come for the root canal of this tooth later. Then we'll go to the second case. So here we can see patient was having a huge swelling, his middle aged patient, 55 to 60 years old. He was diabetic, which was in control. So pain, along with that pain, there was a swelling in the left right lower back tooth region. This is 4-6, I guess. Yes, this is 4-6, and patient was a chronic palm chewer. So now you can see here the above layer of enamel has gone, right? So along with the swelling, the patient had a history of chronic palm chewing, 15 to 20 palm every day. So what happened is the upper layer of enamel got attrited and the pulp is exposed to the external environment. So there is some widening of the pedial space, if you can see here. If I can see here, there is some widening of the pedial space, which led to infection, and there was a huge swelling in the submandibular region. So this patient got submandibular space infection. So what did I write? I wrote augmentin, amoxicillin and clavulinic acid, 625 mg, 3 times daily for 5 days, followed by painkillers like acetylfenac and paracetamol, Zerodol SP, agar aap brand name jana chahenge. Then I gave Pan-D also to this patient. So the patient is now okay, and I have convinced him for a root canal treatment, so he will come next. So proper diagnosis is very much required. Now you see this 5 is also attrited and this 6 is also attrited. All the teeth are attrited. So you have to tell the patient, even after a root canal of this tooth, you may get pain in the other two adjacent teeth. So this has to be informed very well to the patient. So today's video is just about a discussion and when to extract and when to keep. That's all about this video. Then then this was one again aged patient, senior citizen. His age was around 65 years of age, and you can see here I am doing a root canal of this tooth, but I got a doubt and I thought ki let me check again with the carious lesion proximity of this second premolar. Right, so this is the premolar tooth, and here you can see the cavity is almost approximating the pulp of this tooth. So this is not obturation, this is calcium hydroxide paste which I have given inside the canal. So the name of the calcium hydroxide paste which I have given in this canal is UltraCal. It's a very good intracranial medicament, and as you can see here, there is a peripagal lesion in this tooth. So the peripagal lesion, I have not planned to extract the tooth. I will just put calcium for a few weeks and then I will do the obturation. But this, along, what is the use of the x-ray? This x-ray led me to another case, same patient. The first premolar is also involved here and it has to be root canal treated, right? Now this is a very important case. The x-ray is little bit light on the lighter side, so you can see here. If you can't see this picture, I'll just give a closer look here. Yeah, so as you can see here, the tooth is there, right? This is the 2-1 of this patient, and one more, the nose ring is come here. So a few other x-rays I will show you. So the tooth, the crown came out. The patient came to my clinic with the crown of this patient came out. She had got it done somewhere else. And what happened is a customized post was given to this patient 4 to 5 years back. Now there is no tooth structure and all the core has gone. So what I decided is, I decided on to place an implant in this tooth, right? The length of the implant is around 14 mm and width is around 4.2. So we did a traumatic extraction of that particular tooth on the, and the same day we placed the implant over here. So the remaining radiographs I will show you when the patient comes to me next week. Then comes the next case. So this case, as you can see here, this is a lower anterior tooth. It's a little bit tilted here, so if I just can, if did the image and show it to you people. So this is a lower anterior tooth, and see, even after doing the perfect obturation, this canal, there is a little bit abscess in this canal. Why it is so? So basically what has happened, this patient has not put a crown. So if you don't put a crown, there will be marginal leakage and there are 60% chances of failure of the root canal. And even the entrance filling of this patient had, he's a chronic puncturer, so it had come out. And the patient was telling me he's not having any pain, but eventually the periapical lesion will increase and this will lead to failure in the near future. So I have to, what I have told to the patient, I have reduced the occlusal load which was the tooth was getting, and I have told the patient to put a crown. So in these cases, the reason for failure is not putting a crown, right? Now we'll move on to the next case. And yes. So again here, now I will show you a case to you people. So this patient, he was a young patient. So you can see the amount of bone destruction around the root of the tooth. And this treatment had gone for more than a month, or approximately 1.5 months. The patient name is Vikas, 19 years of old age. And he was rather a poor patient and was not able to afford a root canal. So what I offered him is to make the payment in installments and save the tooth. So what I did here is, I started with the root canal, and after, so as you can see here, so this is the periapical lesion at the beginning of the treatment, and during the treatment the periapical lesion has decreased to so much extent, like the patient is very happy, and I have not given the crown yet on this patient. Till now only I have done the obturation. This is not the final x-ray, and this is for the maxillary tooth in which the patient was having problem. So the maxilla is also over, the same kind of carious lesion was there. You can see the amount of, there is no crown only. So I have given, done the root canal treatment of this patient, and I prefer saving the tooth rather than extracting the root, because it's a young patient. Even if the tooth stays for 15 years or 10 years, it will be very fine for the patient as well as me. So then comes this patient, as you can see here, there's a tooth number 8, and she was having some pericoronal flap, inflamed pericoronal flap over this region, and she was 16 to she was approximately 18 years of age. And this patient came to me saying that, sir, can we save that tooth? But here you see it's a third molar and the root formation is still not complete. So I thought, why to not extract it now only, because since the root formation is not complete, we will be able to extract it as very easily rather than doing an impaction at a later stage. So what I did is I extracted the tooth and with very much ease it came out like a jiffy. So what I tell is ki doing all these cases will give you experience. So preliminary radiograph is very very important for all these kind of cases. So hamesha kaam start karne ke pehle ek x-ray zarur le taki usse kafi kuch clarity aa jati hai. Maine cyst bhi diagnose kiya hai, cancers bhi diagnose kiya hai just by taking a small IOPA. Even if you don't have RVG, just take one small IOPA. It is very much required, what I feel in clinical practice. So aur bhi cases dalunga, save karke acche se aapko samjhaunga. Agar aapko mera video pasand aaya to please do ek like to banta hai bhai. Till then take care, goodbye, and follow me on Sci Dental Vlogs Instagram. Chaliye, take care, bye.